Alhamdulillah, summa alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah, Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammadin, kama salaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim, innaka hamidun majid. Allahumma barik ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammadin, kama barakta ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim, innaka hamidun majid. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim, bismillahir rahmanir rahim. اتلو ما اوحي اليك من الكتاب واقم الصلاه ان الصلاه تنهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر ولذكر الله اكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون صدق الله العلي العظيم اما بعد الحمد لله ثم الحمد لله اللهم لك الحمد Walaka shukr. All praise is certainly for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who has given us iman, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has given us this opportunity to witness His creation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created us as human beings, the best of His creation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He deserves all praises for Allah. Allahumma lakal hamd wa lakal shukr. All praise and all thanks is for Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, amongst all the favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has blessed us with, He has given us this opportunity to come to Jummah Salah, to understand this deen, to understand who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is. I'm sure all of us here, we were busy a short while ago. And we started to, since yesterday, we started to put things aside and plan how we are coming to Jummah today. What we're going to put aside, what we're going to do, what we're going to do. Alhamdulillah, we are here. In the time of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the beloved messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in announcing to the people about Islam and about Allah, he went through a very, very, very difficult time. Very, very difficult time. In propagating Islam, in the beginning, the people of Mecca, the tribes, his own family, the people around him, they started to abuse him and ridicule him, and they started to put sanctions. Don't do this with the Rasul, don't do this with them. And it started to become difficult and unbearable at times. Very, very difficult. That the people who are accepting Islam at that point in time, they had to go through a very difficult time. They were denied food, they were denied work, they had to just humble themselves and get by. And this surah, Surah Ankabut, the spider, it was revealed around that time, in that difficult situation, when sometimes you don't know what to do. As we as human beings and brothers, sisters, families, as we face in our lives too, every day sometimes you don't know what to do. Sometimes you think that your problem, it is overbearing. It is so great that it is you alone that have this problem. And what can I do? In that difficult time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He had commanded the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim, Utlu ma uhiya ilayka minal kitab. And recite, Allah is telling the Rasul, and recite what was revealed to you. Recite the Quran. Recite the words of the Quran. Recite what was revealed to you. And this command went to the companions of the Rasul ﷺ, and that command is for us to do. Allah is commanding us, recite what was revealed. Recite the Quran. As Haji was mentioning just now, we have classes in place for us to learn to recite this Quran. This is the time to learn the Quran. This is the time for recitation. This is the time for recitation. And Allah continued in that ayat, وَاقِمُوا الصَّلَاةَ, and establish salat. Establish salat. Inna salata tanha anil fahsha wal munkar. Certainly, salat, the establishment of salat, it protects you from fahsha, from immoral acts, from lewd acts, from acts that are indecent. Salat comes and it overtakes that, and it protects you from wrongdoing actions. Once in the time of the Rasul ﷺ, when they migrated to Medina, some people came to the Prophet ﷺ and complained to the Prophet ﷺ and told him, there is such and such a person, he's a thief, and he's still praying his salat. And listen to this, what salat does for you. The Prophet ﷺ tell them, certainly the salat will cause that bad habit to drop off. It will fall off. So any one of us have a bad habit in us, or we may have a family member that has some bad habit that you want them to knock off, don't nag them about the bad habit. Encourage them for salat. This is the words of Allah and His Messenger. Salat will get rid of that by itself. So encourage one another to turn to salat, and salat will get rid of all the bad problems. So sister, if your husband giving you a problem home with certain things, don't nag him on that. Encourage him on the salat. The bad habit will fall out for itself. All of us have some fault in us, so we should stick to salat. Do the salat. وَلَا ذِكْرُ اللَّهِ أَكْبَرُ, and the remembrance of Allah. The remembrance of Allah is the greatest. It is greatest. It is greater than anything. It is greater than the problems that we have. It is the greatest means of getting Allah's help. It is greater than your problem. Establish salat, the remembrance of Allah, and the recitation of Quran and salat. It is zikrullah, it is akbar, it is the greatest form of remembrance. It is best for you. It is best for you. Wallahu ya'lamu ma tasna'un, and Allah knows what you do. Allah is aware of what you do. So Allah is telling you to recite, read the Quran, establish salat, for it takes away indecency and more immorality and all wrongful acts. Salat takes, for the remembrance of Allah is the greatest, and Allah knows what you do. Allah knows what you do. What Allah is admonishing us here and telling us, do this. Do this. Read your Quran and establish your salat. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in Surah Fajr, Surah 89, Allah mentions in an ayat over there in Surah Fajr, وَجِيءَ يَوْمَئِذٍ بِجَهَنَّمْ وَجِيءَ يَوْمَئِذٍ بِجَهَنَّمْ. On that day, which day? The day of Yawmul Qiyamah, the day of standing in front of Allah. On that day, everything will be called forth and brought towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not just human beings, and every creation will be brought forth in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It will come, everything that is in the first heavens, all the planets and all the creation that is in the first heavens. And the first heaven, it is vast. Everything will be brought forth and called to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The second heaven, the third heaven, the fourth heaven, fifth, sixth, and seventh, everything will be brought forth in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The throne of Allah will be presented there. Jannah, paradise, will be in the right side of the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Jahannam, Allah is telling us in this ayat, وَجِيَ يَوْمَ إِذٍ بِجَهَنَّمْ, and Jahannam will be brought forward. Jahannam will be brought forward in an angry state, roaring, ready for who? The disobedient servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is mentioned in a narration that Jahannam will be so furious on that day of Yawmul Qiyamah, it will be unleashed, and the leash that is holding down Jahannam is 70,000 chains will be holding on the Jahannam, and it will be bringing forth. And why you leash something down? Because it wants to get away. 70,000 chains will be holding down Jahannam, and in each chain, 70,000 angels will be holding the chain. On the day of Yawmul Qiyamah, Jahannam will be furious on that day, waiting, and every one of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala creation will be there looking at Jahannam, fearing. On that day, people will stand up and they will be so nervous. You know, some people, we like to bite our fingernails when we're doing things, we sometimes nervous. The Prophet ﷺ says some people will bite until they eat out, until their elbows. Eat it out, bite it out. That is what will happen on the day of Yawmul Qiyamah. Rasul ﷺ says some people will stand up and they will cry, and they will cry, and they will cry. Tears will fill up until their throats. And then they will have no more tears. And then blood will start to flow from your eyes. Blood will start to flow from your eyes on the day of Yawmul Qiyamah. And what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the ayat after he tells us about Jahannam will be brought in front of us. Massive, chaotic will be the day of Yawmul Qiyamah. Chaotic will be, and then when Jahannam is brought in front of us, Allah mentions in the next ayat in Surah Fajr, what Allah says, يَوْمَ إِذِنْ يَتَذَكَّرُ الْإِنسَانُ وَأَنَّ لَهُ الذِّكْرَ. On that day, man will want to make zikr. Man will want to make zikr on that day. Allah says, no use it will be. No sense it will make. Allah is saying this, not me. He says on that day, that zikr, that he's telling us in the previous surah, the surah when Allah is admonishing us and recite the words of Allah and establish salat, for the zikr of Allah is the greatest, and Allah knows all that we do. On this day, Allah is saying, well, obviously, when we see all this and mankind see all this in front of them, they will want to start to make zikr. You will look for the Quran, you will look to make sajda. Allah says on that day, backs will be straightened. What it means by backs will be straightened? It means that you refuse to prostrate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala whilst we are alive. And the prostration that we are talking about is your five times salat. You refuse to prostrate before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala whilst you are alive. Your back will be straightened on that day. Because when you see the throne of Allah and you witness all of this, you will want to go down in prostration. Allah says on that day, the zikr will be of no use. No use. This is an admonition from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that we should take the Quran, take the salat, do the zikr of Allah. For when Jahannam is brought forth, there will be no acceptance of zikr on that day. This is a serious situation. This is something that we, whilst we are alive, make use of it. We all have to work. We have our family to take care of. But Allah mentions in the Quran, don't let your business and your family deter you from the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Give everything its due portion. Give everything its due portion and you will find ease. You will find ease, my dear respected brothers and sisters. This dunya, we could never catch it. We could never catch it. So let us be cautious. Don't spend all our times trying to get it. Spend some time for the sake of Allah, save your own soul. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us, have mercy on us. Make it easy for us to understand that this zikr that he's talking about, this is your salvation on the day of Yawmul Qiyamah. On that day, when Jahannam is brought forth, nothing else will be accepted on that day. And that is the time when man will want to make zikr. We are the fortunate one. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has warned us about it. وَاَخِرَ دَعْوَانَ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ